YouTube, how's it going? Everything is Tech here with a review of the 64 gig Wi-Fi iPad. So, just my quick thoughts. I gotta say the iPad, it's a marvelous product. Apple did a wonderful job with it. And again, this is a tablet. It's not a notebook. It's not a laptop. It's not a netbook. Laptop and netbook or notebook, it's the same thing. But it's not a laptop or a netbook. It's a tablet. So you definitely shouldn't be comparing the iPad to a laptop. So anyways, let's get right into the review. The first thing you probably notice on the iPad, besides the big screen, is the border. Now, it's a half an inch on the actual screen. And I don't know why people are disappointed with it. I definitely think it's a marvelous feature on the iPad. Without the border, your hands would be on the actual screen, which would get really annoying, especially if you're watching a video or playing games. And believe me on this, iPad, it's a great gaming console as well, a portable gaming console. But I'll get into that later. So, that's the front screen, the home buttons right over there. Turning the iPad are another buttons, the volume up, the increaser, decreaser, and I don't know what to call it, but basically it locks your iPad, so if you want your iPad like that, just turning that button would not allow you to move your iPad, so this screen would stay just as it is over here. So I'm going to go ahead and disable that. And then over in the back we have the sleep button, the microphone, if you could see that well, and then we have the audio input. Then we have the back. The back is definitely one of the best physical features of the iPad. It's the aluminum on the MacBook Pros and the iMac, which is really nice. This is more scratch resistance, unlike the other iPod Touches, where the back is a plastic type of thing, and that scratches like anything. So this is more scratch resistance, and then you have more information about the iPad, the serial number, all that good stuff in the bottom over here. So this is the back, really beautiful. And then there's nothing on this side. And then over here we have the data connector, and then we have the speakers. One thing I do wish is there should be speakers over here as well. That's definitely something I wish Apple would put in, but I don't mind because, you know, the sound quality of the iPad, it's pretty good. Now, let me just dock this. Now, the weight of this is marvelous. It's a little more than 1 pound, and I can definitely have this on one hand for quite a bit of time without actually feeling it. It's really lightweight, and that's definitely a good feature of it being lightweight. So let's go ahead and show you what this baby can do. Let's open this up. This is the front page. You can have about up to 6 icons on the dock over here, but I only have 4. I don't know. I just like 4. And then let's show you some video. Go ahead and take this out. And I'm going to show you Toy Story 2. Okay. And here we go. Now, I'm sorry about the reflection in the back. That's a little annoying, so you couldn't see the best quality. But this video I was viewing is full 720p. It was 1280 by 720, but the iPad's resolution is about 1024 by 786, something like that. So it's not, the iPad resolution is not full 720p, but videos on this that 720p look pretty much the same as it would on a computer, just a little difference. You couldn't even notice it, believe me, from the first sight. It looked pretty much the same. So that's pretty much the video quality and sound quality. Hopefully I don't get any problems with YouTube. I'm going to show you the mic. The mic's on the top over here, and I recorded this while making one of the videos. And I'll just record another one. Hello. Stop it. And then play. And that's the quality. It's pretty good, and you can definitely use the mic for different purposes as well. Now, that's basically the iPad at a first glance. It's definitely a great product. Oh yeah, I forgot games. Whoops, sorry about that. I'm gonna shoot. So here we are in the game. It looks fantastic. And to move, just like that. To walk. I don't know, it has some... Okay, got it. So the joystick to move, to shoot. And this is pretty much gaming on the iPad. It's definitely really good. I don't know. The level should be longer for some games. But overall, the games are really good for the iPad. That's the games. And that's pretty much all I have to say about the iPad. It can do many things, many awesome things. But now, the pricing for the iPad, it's $500 for the 16 gig Wi-Fi, and then the 16 gig Wi-Fi and 3G is $629. So an extra $130 from the Wi-Fi. So the 64 gig cost me $700. So it's pretty much not that bad. I have no problems with the iPad so far. So my bottom line about the iPad is it's a great piece of work. Apple did a marvelous job. Although Apple made the iPad, it's a beautiful product once again. The developers made the iPad touch the sky. That's all I gotta say. Apple made their product, I give them credit, but developers made the software, made the apps, made all the things, all the features just come alive on the iPad. For example, you can print right from the iPad to a wireless printer. So that's really nice. You have pages, so you can type. You go ahead and just type on the iPad, make Word documents right off the iPad. And then, of course, you can do much more. So developers have made the iPad touch the sky. That's all I have to say. So, again, thank you for watching. Don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe. Please do like this video if you enjoyed it. And I'll have more reviews coming up, especially about the Apple iPad dock and many more products. So, again, once again, thank you for watching.